with bricks, with bricks, with bricks. Relax with bricks, with bricks. Relax, Afawax. Relax, will you?
Hello, Afawax. Well, I mean, many things are happening today, but number one, I'm in the Lego shed without, I repeat, without my baggy wizard sleeves. Thank you. And I have got the door open, so there might be some small visitors throughout the build. But anyway, let's get down to today's business. As you know, we are moving our minifigs. Let's just have a quick pan from the old bleachers to the new bleachers. And before everyone moves over, they get a day on the cloud. And today's go on the cloud is... It's Hannah Ra. Oh, hello, Hannah Ra. Hello, Hannah Ra. Hello, Emma. Hello. Long time no see. We've a few of us have been at the back of the bleachers for what feels like forever. Yes, I'm sorry about that. You're not wrong, Hannah Ra. There's a lot of silent partners. In the Alpha White gang, yes, a lot of silent partners. Yes, a lot of silent partners, but it doesn't mean you're any less important. No less important. No. So anyway, enjoy your time on the cloud today. Yes, I'll enjoy it. Can I have a quick tremble? Yes, you can have a quick tremble. I feel fizzy. Oh, good grief, it's still ongoing. Oof, what a tremble it is. Yes, it's quite the tremble. It's quite the tremble. Anyway, did you enjoy that? Yes, I very much enjoyed the tremble. Thank you. I'll go over there now, please. Yes, I'll crest forth on the cloud over there. Thank you. Put me in the shard of sunlight. Yes, I will. I will put you in the shard of sunlight. Oh, will you look at her magnificence. Anyway, there it is, Hannah Ra. I'm very much enjoying doing this. We should maybe do it once a year. Right, without further ado, let's null bag three. If any of you are hoping and praying for things that aren't grey today, I'm afraid I've got bad news. Now the Pearson. Right, off we go. We have a minifig today, and this is, you've got to put them together. This is just consulting the box. This is a droid called IG-11. IG-11. Okay. IG-11. Yep. Hold on. Not mad about these types of minifigs, you know. They have no emotional resonance for me. Absolutely none. So that's the basis of that, then that. Well, we have got a little face. We have got a face. I mean, he doesn't look too bad, does he? I mean, I suppose if you've seen The Mandalorian, this will obviously, it may well have emotional resonance for you, but it doesn't have any emotional resonance for me, I'm afraid. I mean, maybe he's like, you know, you'd love him as much as you love. Oh, where does that go then? Oh, okay. What? Really? We're sticking that into the middle of his back? Well, that doesn't work, does it? Where does it go? It doesn't go there. What? What? How does that work? Eh? There's absolutely no way that's going in there. Oh, well, I mean, I say this and then it does go in, doesn't it? Oh, good gosh. Oh, crumbs. That was... Well, I can't see for the life of me how that works. But look, there's that. And this is supposed to go in here. But look. That's an absolute mystery. Where does it go? Am I just being stupid as per usual? Definitely. I mean, that's not going it. Oh, God, nobody say a word. Nobody say a word. Nobody say a word. Nobody say a word. Nobody. Nobody. No. Thank you. Thank you. Nobody say a word. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, look, it does work. It's almost as if, like, I know what they're doing, isn't it? Shh. Just be quiet. Just be absolutely silent. Thank you. That goes there. And he's packing heat. IG-11, isn't he? Flipping heck. He means business. And he's holding... That doesn't really work. This one will go in this hand. There you go. So there we have it. IG-11. Hello. Welcome to the haunted table. I sort of hate you. Anyway, there we go. I mean, I haven't seen The Mandalorian, so... As I say, I have no emotional attachment to him. Right. We've sort of tethered in, so we will commence immediately with the Google Eyes. TVZ, 1, 2, 3. TVZ, 1, 2, 3. She says, hello to you today anyway, TVZ, 1, 2, 3. She says, I'm not a goose. What? 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 You're missing out on your alphabet gang member pack and your badge and your picture and your what? You're crazy. You could be an official goose. You could be a big goose. What? You could be a golden goose. You could be a super goose. Super goose. What? Or you could go mad and be an extra goose. What? What? Not a goose. Just get on with it, damn it. Yeah, all right. Okay, sorry. I'm not a goose, so technically I can't request, but I really enjoyed the VW camper van, which you've probably already done. No, actually, no. I haven't built the VW camper van on air, as 'twere. I have offered. That has been something that I have offered to do, and... I'm very happy to take it apart and do it again. In fact, I actually think someone did ask at some point, so maybe I should put that on the list of things to do. Or at least remember it. But yeah, okay, yep. And I have the Beetle and a Harley Davidson to build. I'm sure some geese might enjoy those. Along those lines, I wish Lego would do a Vespa. Yes, actually, they should do a Vespa. I'll totally build one of those. Of course, they've got a miniature Vespa. They've got that. That bit of technic wrangling that closed out today's episode was wheezing juice and fun. Thanks, Mother Goose. It's almost as if people like it when I really make mistakes. It's almost as if, isn't it? Almost as if. Don't think I don't know everything about all of you. Oh, hang on. Here she comes. Here she comes. We haven't had her for a couple of days. Come on then. Sorting out your nunks? Yeah, sorting out my nunks. Right. Yeah, all right, Dolly, that's in, yeah. This is an absolute nightmare. Never a true word spoken, you muppet. Yeah, I know, I know. Why does it all have to be so very, very grey? This build is the colour of despair and surrender. Yeah, I know. Is your eye all right there? Yeah. Just checking. I know, this is the nature of the Star Wars build. It's why we very rarely do them, Dolly Neptune. But you know, we must do them sometimes because there are people who like Star Wars. There's people who like Star Wars. Yes, yes. People who actually like Lego Star Wars. Yes. Absolutely. If you please, can you help me? No, I can't because there's no... Everyone's being very rude about Star Wars fans. Have you noticed? It's absolutely unacceptable. I mean, I am a Star Wars fan, but I am not a fan of the Star Wars Lego. There's no doubt about it. But, you know, it's fine to do these things every now and again. Especially for those who like these things. You know, we're not just all about the fancy free and the toorooloo here at Relax with Bricks. No. Sometimes we need to get our hands dirty and get our little fingers into the mud of grey Lego. That's what needs to happen every now and again. By the way, can I just give an enormous shout out to Tim Goff. And the Tweedle Twins, actually, today. I got parcels from both of them today, which is exceptional. The Tweedle Twins have sent me a whole load of minifigs, of which this is my favourite. Will you look at it? I mean, that is one of the greatest minifigures ever, isn't it? I absolutely love it. And a lot of other minifigs. But Tim Goff has sent me a set that actually made me laugh out loud. I'm not going to show it to you. I'm going to keep it secret, but we are going to build it. I think we will stick to Story of Nian next, but then we will do the Tim Goff build, and I'm keeping it total secret as to what it is. It is ridiculous. It is ridiculous. You're going to love it. She was from Canada and then we didn't think she was from Canada and then it turned out she was from Canada. It's will you be? She screams, and I'm not exaggerating here, she screams, baby, yodery! She screams it, and there's about a trillion exclamation marks. Keith Pearson's jokes are fab. I love them all. I'm okay with the Star Wars sets. Just make pew-pew noises, pretending you are shooting aliens or whatever they shoot at in the Wars of Stars. Sharon Ranzulli, Last Tango in Halifax, is amazing. Ditto for all of Sally Wainwright projects, Scott and Bailey, is my fave, eh? Pew pew. I'm very much enjoying the pew pew. Pew pew. Pew pew. I'll tell you what, let's make it a rule now that from here on, during this build, if at any point it's getting too much, we just all go pew pew. That's it. And we'll see if that fixes it. Pew pew. I can already feel a pew pew coming on. Pew pew pew. Oh, pew pew. Oh, massive pew pew. Hang on, am I even doing this correctly? Good grief. Hang on. Oh, pew. Oh, double pew pew. Pew pew with knobs on. Get in there. Just get in. Get in, you absolute son of a gun. Crumbs alive, Technics. I've done it. I've done it. I've done it. Cease the pew pew. Pew pew can now end. Thank you. No more pew pew. Thank you. Thank you. Eric. He's got a duck of Fazio. They both like watching Lego. And they really like musical. So his name is Eric. Fum, etc. He says, okay. So Technics was the part of the treehouse build where I had to attach one part of the partly built base to another section of partly built base, and after struggling thought, there is no way in hell this is supposed to attach to that. Yes, that's Technics in a nutshell. Yes, that is Technics. That is Technics. Then he says, I suppose now I should start watching The Mandalorian, especially since one of my brothers has been bothering me to stop watching. You call yourself a Star Wars fan, but you haven't watched it yet. It's like the old school Star Wars we grew up with. Isn't it? But you can only watch it, can't you, if you've got Disney Plus. That's the, I do believe, which I haven't got, but I do believe that is the case. Please tell me if I'm wrong, in which case I'll watch it. His name is Rio, and he really likes Lego, and he really likes other things that rhyme with Lego. He says, hold on, Rio Reborn, just tethering in. He says, Dad, I've watched the part of season one, but I gave up. It is more like the first 3, 4, 5, 6 than the rest, and I see why the fans love it. But I found it a little boring. Don't stone me. We won't stone you. There will be no stoning here, Rio Reborn. You can walk easy. Walk easy amongst the men again. Meljo, hello. Meljo. A recent goose. But a goose nonetheless. She says, watching at the moment with my 12-year-old, he loves it. I'd have to agree with Rio, the first eps are the best. I keep wondering if Mother Goose has noticed any pink frogs missing from the bonsai since the child, aka Baby Yoda, has arrived on the table. No? Why would they go missing? Why would pink frogs go missing with Baby Yoda? Huh. Oh no. Oh no, he doesn't eat them, does he? Oh no. I don't know if I want to know. Don't tell me. Noreen, she says, a baby Yoda, the child. I have no words, too cute. Oh, this build is so colourful and easy peasy. I will babysit Baby Yoda if and when needed. I'm about to buy the police station. Double points, can't wait. Oh, well done. I did something really annoying. Well, it's not really annoying. I've purchased the space sets as requested by the Gooses, and then noticed today, I mean, obviously it's double points, so that's super, but noticed today that I've done it too soon. There's a new gift with purchase coming, which I've missed out on, which I'm furious about. I'm furious about it. Ooh, hang on now. It's always the problem, isn't it, with the old gifts with purchase. I wish they would just tell you when they're coming at the beginning of the year. Just give us a diary, please, Lego, of when the GWPs are coming, and then you can plan accordingly.
Oh, good grief, this is hurting my brain and heart. Oh, crumbs. Which,
Okay. Did you ever think that getting something in a hole would be that hard? Oh, I could just do it again. Just boing yourself. Lego all around. Oh, hello, you're new. Hello. Lego all around says, nice, I have that set and I love it. Hello. Hello to you. You get a double clap because you're new. Lego all around. Hannah Forbes says, a day on the cloud. How lovely. Yes, you deserved it. You utterly deserved it. You deserve nothing but the best. Eric Oswald says, eek, I didn't realise the Julian B song had a scream at the end. Rude. Rude. Meljo and the counting added into it without missing a beat. Rude. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Janet Pendlebury. Oh, we love Janet Pendlebury. Hang on, Janet Pendlebury. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Where's this? What? Ooh, ooh. Oh, okay, right, fine. It's around this way. I was having a minor panic. Thank you for coming to my very minor panic because I'm dealing with technics and I don't know what I'm doing. Thanks for coming. Thank you for coming. Four of these little monkeys. Janet Pendlebury says, just an idea, but maybe you should rule up your little Book of Morons with a larger area at the right-hand side and a smaller area in the middle. By the way, I do not like Star Wars, never seen an entire film, but do really enjoy all the Lego builds of the craft and people, etc. Yes, that's a good point, well made, Janet Pendlebury. Vis-a-vis the lining in the Book of Morons, every single time without fail, I forget what's supposed to be in the right-hand column. That's mostly what happens there. Will you look at it? We might have to go five. Will you look at it? We've had to go five, gang. Oh, God. Sorry, are you grizzling? Yes, I'm grizzling. I'm grizzling. Because it's just really hard. Is it not really though, is it? Shut up. Just be quiet. Right, we're off to the Twitter Rise. Twitter Rise do do ba do ba do Twitter Rise do do ba do ba do Twitter Rise do do ba do ba do Twitter Rise Twitter Rise do do ba do ba do Twitter Rise do do ba do ba do Twitter Rise do do ba do do ba do. Mr. Graham Triggs, the VAR, the official referee of Relax with Bricks. Hang on, Mr. Graham Triggs, I've got to count. 1, 2, 3. Thank you. Adjudication. Oh, no. Oh, no. Adjudication. Mother Goose to pick up the Lego shed and move it. I mean, surely he jests. Aside. Not really. Oh, you absolute wag. Oh, hang on, where's that going? I think it's going here. Stop grizzling. Stop it. It's very hard to see. Oh, I see there. Hang on, I'm tethering in, Mr. Graham Triggs. Just hold your horses, please. Just hold on. Hold on. Oh, look, this looks important. It's grabby. Ah. Right. Thank you. Turn the page. Mr. Graham Triggs, the VAR, the official referee of Relax with Bricks. If you really wanted to stop the two-tone effect, you could just put a blind on the window, although that would mean we wouldn't get any sunlight. Or your massive bush. I'm not saying a word. I'm not saying a word. Professor, leg out. I have not forgotten, Mother Goose. It's time for a Professor Leg Out Pal. Today's poll, should Mother Goose deconstruct the current progress on the Liza Minnelli and Falcon due to the loss of the time-lapse recording in order to start over? Oh no, please God no. I haven't seen the result yet. I'm just bracing myself, I'm bracing. Right, here it comes.
In fourth place, with 0%, it's yes to leave as is. In third place, with 5% of the vote, it's see to not undoing progress.
I see what you've done here, Professor Lego. I love you for it.
In second place, with 21% of the vote, it's 9 to disassembly. And 74% of the vote, it's push poll off the table.
Thank God. Thank God.
For those unsure what the Liza Minnelli and Falcon is, imagine the Millennium Falcon, except one below, except all the Care Bears threw up all over it.
Well, you just wait and see. You just wait and see what it's going to be like, because I've got plans. I've got plans. Ring, ring. Yes, hello, Relax with Bricks.
Yes, hello, it's Katie Hall.
Oh, yes, hello, Katie Hall. What can I do for you?
I'm just phoning to pick up... Professor Leggett on something, because they're not called Care Bears. They're called Ewoks. Thank you.
Yes, they're called Ewoks. Rude. How dare you, Professor Leggett, call them Care Bears.
Professor Leggett, I'm guessing by now you've discovered the 3 1x3 sand yellow bricks were from step 45 or step 6 of bag 2. How did you fare with the required disassembly?
Well, actually, I did it pretty well. Look, they're in. I got them in and I didn't have to take it all apart, so that's a win. That's a win, isn't it?
Yes!
It's a win. That's what I call a win. It's going in here, look. It's going in here. I mean, look, don't complain, because at least there's some red and blue today. Grand Moff Parry. Oh, good God, I love him. Never-ending boing, Gary Blair, never-ending boing, Gary Blair.
He says, who the heckin' who said I didn't like Star Wars?
What?
That's why I corrected you.
What? Do you know what, Gary Blair? I genuinely thought you hated Star Wars. Well, there can be no complaints then. Oh, where's this going? I think it's going here. I mean, I'm sort of guessing, which is never good.
Just stick me in the blair hole now if you like. Don't care what flavour of custard creams, vanilla you say, # rest my case, # malted milks, hours, # dictator, # shove your authority.
Oh dear. Well, good luck. Good luck. By the way, Mr. Graham Triggs, I have put in a formal request to Georgie Gobbon that custard creams are now purchased for the purpose of incarcerating Mr. John Parry. She took it reasonably well. It goes that way, doesn't it? Thank you. She took it reasonably well. I mean, she just spends most of her time staring at me with a sort of, what's the word I'm looking for? A disdain that is infinite. I think that's the best way I can describe it.
Professor Leggett, given the general mood towards this build, let me say I'm more than happy you're building it. It isn't Lego's fault. Almost every vehicle or craft in the Star Wars universe likes to be grey.
Yes, that is true.
I think we should enjoy it for what it is, a different type of build from normal.
Yes, I completely agree with you. I completely agree with you. And as has now been long established, absolutely nobody is here for the actual building. Are they? Really? 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 I don't think so. I don't think so. It's a conduit for fun, is it not? It's a conduit for chit-chat on a daily basis with our chums. That's what it is. That's what it is. Ooh, where does this go? Ooh, ooh, it's quite hard to see. Ooh, 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 ooh. I could just grizzle for all of this, but I'm not going to. Grumpy Mark. I'm really enjoying this build. The constant moaning and complaining by the other Afawax really cheers me up. He loves being grumpy. And at least I now don't have to watch The Mandalorian, seeing how, spoiler alert, you gave away the surprise ending of the first series right at the end of Club Business.
Oh no, did I? Oh no! Oh no! Oh no!
How? What? I mean, I can't even remember what it was. Oh no! Did I read out some? Well, that wouldn't have been me. That would have been me reading out somebody giving away the surprise spoiler. I must apologise in full. Oh dear. Oh dearie, 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 dear. Gosh, that's bad, isn't it? Sorry. I can only say in my defence, didn't have a clue, because obviously I haven't seen it. And also, brilliantly, I have forgotten what it even was. So, well done me. Well done me. Professor Lego, he comes to my defence, like the gentleman he is. And he says, "And Mr. Fuzz, I don't believe she realised she was." Grumpy Mark says, yes, I should have said inadvertently given away. Yes, I did inadvertently give it away. But it's quite good that I can't now remember what I even gave away. So, yay me. Eric, get the fluff out of your sockets. Is that a new euphemism? Look, I don't know what you're talking about. Euphemisms here on Relax with Bricks. How dare you, sir? How dare you? Kath Pearson, I'm not sure that Fluffy Pockets isn't the new wizard sleeve. Oh, no. Professor Lego,
are Fluffy Pockets also wizard sleeve? I said Fluffy Pockets. I said wizard sleeve. Or can a person have Fluffy Pockets? I said Fluffy Pockets. Along with a wizard slave, I said wizard slave.
And then Eric says, oh, was it pockets? I said pockets. I heard sockets. I said sockets. Professor Lego said,
I believe I used both words in conjunction with the fluff. I said fluff.
Thank you. Pew pew. Pew 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 pew. Pew pew. Pew 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 pew. See, it's good when you pew pew. Should have pew pewed earlier when I was pew pewing that blinking pew pew. There we go. Oh, we're getting through it quite quick though. Stan's mum, read the current build. When do we get to the good stuff? Is there good stuff? # stick a few yellow bricks in, no one's looking. Yeah, Tanya says yes to yellow bricks. Look, there's some red ones.
Just shut up moaning. Stop moaning, the pair of you.
Professor Lego,
I wasn't actually buying with the suggestion of cleaning the lightning socket. I said socket on the iPhone for mostly carrying my phone in my pocket. I said pocket. Bits of dust or fluff. I said fluff. Get in, and when I next charge, I get compacted against the back of the socket. I said compacted, and I said socket. Over time, it builds up and eventually can interfere with a proper connection of whatever you're plugging. I said plugging into the phone, such as a microphone. The toothpick recommendation was for something non-metallic.
Yes, thank you, Professor Lego. Never-ending Boinger, who's now called the Mandaborian, says, "What the chuff is a baby yodel?" It's not a yodel. It's a baby Yoda. Baby Yoda. Although, if you have yodeling requests, if you have a request for Baby Yoda to yodel any song of your choosing, then please let me know. Yeah, thank you. Thank you. Okay. Little soup. finally. Oh, we've got little Sue. She's little and she's called Sue. She's little Sue.
Yes, hello. Crumbs, you took your time getting to me today, didn't you, Emma?
Yes, I did take my time getting to you today, yes, but you're here now.
Yes, I'm here now. I mean, it's only 31 minutes in, but gee whiz. I mean, for goodness sake. You know, there's lots of people, and they're just waiting for me to come up with my opinions.
Yes, I know this, yes.
Anyway, I've got an official request.
Hang on. Do I need to actually write this in? Hang on a minute.
Wait, because you're about to make a terrible mistake. Or are you about to? Yes, you've missed out loads, Emma. You need to go back. Pew-pew.
Pew-pew. Pew-pew. Pew-pew. Yes, thank you for pew-pewing. Yeah.
I have an official request, Emma. Please, could we pick up the Lego shed and move it? So we don't have the sun streaming in.
You won't want me to write that in the request book?
No, because I'm only joking, Emma. Ha ha ha, in your face.
Rude.
I mean, anyone with half a brain would know that this was a joke, of course. I absolutely love the sun streaming in the window, and I think it is beautiful, and official request to ignore my official request, thank you. Also, please, to the child, the baby Yoda, joining me at my cafe, because I can't believe how little he is, an actual person.
I mean, he's so little. He's so little.
You're late.
Yes, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Yes, buzzer, buzzer.
Right. Look, that's going in there like that. But we're doing well here. We're doing well. Professor Legout, TV said 1, 2, 3 spoilers. Spoilers. Spoilers! Oh, okay. It was TVZ. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Spoilers. Don't. Everyone will have forgotten by the time they get round to watching it. Don't worry, everybody. Don't worry. Don't worry. It's easily done. Easily done.
Emma.
Yes.
You know when you sometimes are doing Bricks and Pieces by Professor Lego.
Yes.
Bricks and pieces. A fa da da da, a fa da 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 da.
Yes.
Well, you know when you're doing it, and you always ask about the O with the line for it, and you say no one ever tells you how to pronounce it.
Yes.
Well, it's pronounced like the U in the word bun, like it's pronounced it's a Norwegian letter, actually. I looked it up. It's pronounced bun. That's how it's pronounced, but press the button.
Thank you. Stan's mum says, we should all be more Norwegian. The world would be a happier place. Amen. Kath Pearson, what's big grey and goes round and round? I don't know, Kath Pearson. What's big grey and goes round and round? An elephant in a washing machine. Thank you. Hashtag grey jokes. Hashtag joke a day keeps the boring away. Thank you. Yes, it does. Trevor Poulter. New. And new. Says, oh dear, oh dear. Trevor Poulter has gone there. He said, what's the story behind the set that cannot be named? Intriguing. Oh no. Oh, Trevor. Oh, Trevor. It was just a big blue fist. Let's just leave it at that. It was a great big blue massive fisting. That we all received, and we lost the will to live. And for the first time ever in Relax with Bricks history, I lost it, and speed built the rest of it to get it out of the way and done. And the relief that was then felt was quite extraordinary. But Professor Lego explains,
Mother Goose had such a horrible time building set 70839.
The correct reference, yes.
That it became the build that shall not be named.
Trevor Porter says, I always wanted that set, but perhaps it was a good escape. Oh, John Perry.
Though, John Perry, he likes tiles and he also likes getting into massive amounts of trouble. You're allowed to say Rex Celsior now.
I'm sorry, I won't accept it. I will not accept it. Adjudication, please, Mr. Graham Triggs. Adjudication, please, Mr. Graham Triggs. Adjudication. I will not have it. He keeps saying it. And he gets into no trouble for doing it. Please, sir. Please. Please. Please, sir. Please, sir.
Professor Lego says the rule breaker.
Yes, he is a rule breaker. Yes, Neil says, I recall Mr. the VAR made it into a Christmas carol and it made it cushy. Hashtag Hosanna. And this is just not right. It's not right.
Though, correct Neil, although I don't respect his authority, the professor does. So he should know this hashtag Rex Celsior.
I mean, please. Then Cass Pearson. After the Zingbao little toy shop of horrors, all was forgiven for Rex Celsior. And you've said it as well. Everyone's getting out of control. Oh, we've got a big sticker coming up. Hang on. Oh, this is going to put a cat among the pigeons. Ruth Hayes says, you said protuberance. Yes, I did. I'm sorry, I can't apologise enough. Trevor Poulter, Mother Goose, can I request that you do not build the Lamborghini Sian as a combination of Technic and car? Might just be the end of RWB when we see you being taken away as a gibbering wreck. Then of course the never-ending Boinger, and of course John Perry. Just do it gifts, and on that bombshell, we conclude the business of club. Right, now then, we've got a big moment coming up here. We've got stickers. We've got to do this first. Oh, could pinch your fingers in that. Right, sticker. Sticker number 9. Sticker number nine. It's a big one, isn't it? Sticker number 9. Oh, I'm slightly afeard of this. Sticker number 9. No. Yes. Okay. Where's that going? There. Right. Obviously, we're doing one on this side. Oh, I see it goes there. Right. Yep. Molly's padding round the shed. FYI. She hasn't quite come to see me yet, though. Hello, Moles. Are you sniffing round where the mouse was? Yeah, as if that's gone. Sticker number 4. Sticker number four. Hello, Molly. Sticker number 4. This way. Oh, actually, that's all right. That's all right. I can live with that. Only stuck there by one little thing. Okay. Now what? Oh, it's Technics Ahoy. Okay.
That's a fascin.
Look, skis. Oh, that was painful. Oh, we've got to turn it upside down. Yes. Oh crumbs, gang. Oh, absolute crumbs. Oh no, I've knocked everyone over. Hang on. Okay. Oh, I've knocked Noreen over. Skipper Fingers took a in the face. Trevor the not the stormtrooper. IG-11 went for a Burton, the scout trooper. Hope they're in the right place. I mean, we can only dream, can't we? Is that actually in? Oh, crumbs alive. Alright, I think it is down. Oh, I mean that's quite good. All right. Then, oh, except it's made it really wibbly wobbly now. Why on earth have they done that? Oh, Lego. I've now got to keep a hand on it at all times. How does that work? Oh, okay. Hang on, so it's that way round. I couldn't be more furious that they've put these legs on before, while we're still having to press things down. What's the likelihood of me forgetting? Especially when you've got to press things quite hard. That's quite a good effect though, isn't it? Look. Well, oh, sorry. Sorry, Mandalorian. Sorry. We're almost done for today. I mean, I'm presuming that the next thing's going to happen is all the moving parts. I presume. Where's that go? What? What? Oh, okay. I get it. It's just that. Thank you. Thank you for coming to my very minor panic. It's now over and has concluded. Thank you for coming to it. There won't be any more today because that's the last bit. Three cheers and hooray. Well, there we have it. That was bag three. Bag four. Oh, all right. bag four is more of the same. So anyway, come back for that. And the good news is we've got, hang on, we've got five, we've got four, five, and I think we've only got six bags. So, okay. All right then, lovely. Come back tomorrow, my darling Afwax, and we will continue all the fun. And I will see you then, Afwax forever. Bye-bye. No. We're not finished because, of course, Hannah R. Will you look at the tremble? Will you look at the minor tremble? Your time is now concluded upon the cloud. Thank you. Have you had a lovely time? Yes, I've had a lovely time in the sunshine. It's been really super. Yes, well done. Good. So thank you. Thank you very much for being a goose. Makes the world a difference. My pleasure. And now you will crest forth to the new bleachers. Yes, I'll crest forth. I am going to crest forth. Cresting forth. Cresting forth. Hello, baby Yoda. Yes, okay, thank you. Cresting forth to the new bleachers. There we go. Super, let's give you a little close-up. There we go. It's turning out lovely over there, isn't it? Super. Right, I will definitely see you tomorrow. Goodbye.